Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. I'm delighted to have Shikha Ji with us. And today she is going to explain something very beautiful she was telling me. So the stage is all over to you and welcome to Exotic Astrology. Please enlighten us.
Thank you, Babaji Ji. So today I have chosen a topic which is a little different. Nadi, I have not taken the basics as such, because in Nadi we know there are so many Nadi Granthas. There is Bhrigu Nandi Nadi, Saptarishi Nadi, Meena Nadi, Shukra Nadi. So many Nadis are there. So the system that I follow is Bhrigu Nandi Nadi. It is a combination of Bhrigu Nadi and Nandi Nadi. Aji Rao Sahib Ji has done so much work on this. He had done work on Bhrigu Nadi and Nandi Nadi, and he came up with a book named as Bhrigu Nandi. Now this book has 425 example charts.
Wow.
And this book is so difficult to decipher without a guru or a teacher who is teaching you, because he has just given a chart and he has said so and so person has married in so and so year, he has so many children, his wife is like that, without giving the logics behind it. Means logics are there, but he has not disclosed in this particular book.
Okay.
So book is a little difficult to decipher. And basically there are two types of nadis. Again, one is a Jiva Nadi and the Jiva Nadis. The Jiva Nadis are one that generally people talk about, the thumb impressions and those very, very old parchment papers and all that. So Sir A.V. Sundaram Ji says ki these are very difficult to handle and really sattvic people, and they change from person to person. Means the same line will change for you when you are having to give on. And it will change for me when I am. So these are the speaking nadis. They have life in them.
Okay.
What we are studying, like all this Meena Nadi, Shukra Nadi, Chandrakala Nadi, these are Ajiva Nadis.
Okay.
Bhrigu Nadi, Saptarashi Nadi. All these are books, means literature in Nadi.
They are known as Ajiva Nadis.
Ajiva. Ajiva means without. Jiva and Ajiva.
Okay. Okay. Interesting.
Yeah. So in this Nadi also, we don't follow any Dasha system.
Oh,
we don't follow any Vargas charts, nothing. We just take normal natal chart, that is D1 chart.
Okay.
And only work on that, and total Nadi is based on that.
Okay.
Most of the time, the Lagna also is not important. Only the combinations of the planets and the characters of planets. Of course, when since I am already into KP astrology, and I knew Parashar from pretty long time, and even the teacher who has taught me, we gelled both Parashar and this thing. So we have come to better conclusions.
Okay.
Better way of deciphering a chart.
Okay.
So Lagna does play an importance. In some charts, even Aji Rao has taken Lagnas also, Nakshatras also. So this is not very something very different that we are doing. Nothing is like I have done this. No. Everything is there in the books. Everything is there in the Vedas. We just have learned them and know how to use them a little bit better. Like it.
Okay. I'm very eager to watch.
Yeah. So the people can just sit with a pen and a pencil after this, because I'm going to teach and they can do it simultaneously. Let me share my work. If you give me permission to share, I can share.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Yeah. Please give me permission to share.
I don't know how they give permission to share.
Yeah, see in security, if you go and click over there, then you can see over there, share, and then you have to just click there.
I'll just pause this recording just a minute. Okay, so I've given you the permission. You can check now.
So I'll just share.
Yeah.
Okay, so this technique is known as locked Bhagya Chakra. This technique is known as locked Bhagya Chakra, And in Nadi system, as I told you, we only take the karakatvas of planets and progression of planets. Okay. So basically in Nadi, we divide the 12 houses into 4 tribes. Just as we do Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha. But in this, the Lagna is fixed. It is always Aries. Okay. So Aries, Leo and Sagittarius, wherever they are in your chart, does not matter. They fall in the east direction. That is fixed. So whether whatever ascendant you are, it does not matter. Have you understood this point?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because in my chart, if I am, suppose say, Gemini ascendant, so my dharma will become Gemini and the trine belonging to it. But in correct. This, it is not like that.
Kama house, yes.
Yeah. So it does not change over here.
Okay.
So it has become more easier to do it. I have just put it like this. So east direction, the directions are important in Nadi. Means it is east, north, 4 main directions. East, south, west, north. Okay. So Aries, Leo, Sagittarius are eastern direction. Correct?
Yes.
And
these are like the fire signs are all the east and west is like all the Kama signs.
Correct. And Artha is all the south.
Okay.
And the water signs are all the north signs.
Okay.
So, pretty easy this is. So, these are the, I have just put it like this. Now, the important thing is like, in Nadi, there is a system like we have aspects in Parashar. All the planets expect the 7th house and Mars, Saturn and Jupiter are having special effects, aspects. In Nadi, all the planets in the trine aspect each other.
Okay.
And this aspect is very, very strong.
Okay.
So that day we had done the trinal session with you. So you were very right. This is the basics of Nadi.
Okay.
So people, so planets in trines are as good as sitting together in one. We can move them anywhere in these three trines.
Okay.
Okay. So very simple thing you have to do is, you have to, suppose I write a planet, whatever planets in eastern direction, that is 1, 5 and 9.
Okay.
I will write them together.
Okay.
Okay. Same way I will do with 2, 6 and 10.
Okay. So when you say eastern, then it means Aries, Leo and Sagittarius, just to reiterate. Not 1, 5, 9 houses. That can be any house. Okay. Any sign?
Yeah. Any house, sign is important.
Yes. Any Lagna, it is, we must check Aries, Leo and Sagittarius.
Correct. Okay. And south is Taurus, Virgo and Capricorn.
Okay.
Okay. And west is, as you said, Gemini, Libra and Aquarius. Correct?
Yes.
So, we just have to note down the planets. We have to make them sitting in each these directions. The planets sitting in each directions together. We have to just note down together.
Okay.
Okay. Now, what is a log bhagya? If I do this, I will find the planets in different directions.
Okay.
So, if in now, whichever planet is retro,
okay.
Like Rahu Ketu are always retro.
Okay.
So suppose Rahu is sitting in Leo.
Yes.
So he will be 100% in Leo, but his effect on Cancer sign will be 50%.
Okay, the previous sign.
Previous sign.
Okay, and
retrograde because it is going behind.
Okay, I would like to interrupt you here. So this chart which you are showing, this is of the Kalpurush Aries ascendant. So do you suggest that whichever lagna, whichever person has, irrespective of that, they can make Aries as their first.
Yeah, yeah. And yes, then, yes, yes.
So that it's yes, easier yes. for them. Otherwise, they
correct, will be correct. No. They have to start with their lagna only. But writing down the planet systematically is, we always start from Aries, Leo and Sagittarius, the Eastern. Okay.
Correct.
Wherever it falls in your chart. So there is a proper system to go about.
Okay.
One day you write lagna, the next day you write East, then you will get confused.
Okay. You mean then, that we should write our lagna only and then we should assign the planets as per directions according?
Correct.
Okay. Perfect.
Okay. So retro planets are to be taken in two houses. So you need to write in Leo, Rahu, and give that retro sign 100% and 50% in Cancer.
Okay.
Rahu is written here also and here also. Ketu is written here also.
Okay.
Though in today's this thing, Rahu and Ketu will not play a part. I will explain how. So today's concept is grouping according to their primes and Lok Bhagya Chakra. Now, if there are no planets in any of the primes, then that prime becomes Lok.
Okay.
And if only Rahu and Ketu are alone sitting in that prime, they are not counted.
Okay.
So suppose if your 3, 7, 11 is empty, but Rahu or Ketu is sitting on it, it will be still counted as an empty prime.
Okay. Interesting.
Okay. No other planet sitting in one of the primes, then it is called as an empty prime, and this empty prime becomes locked.
Okay. It's called as locked.
Yeah, so in people who have this locked chakra,
yes,
locked, it is called as a locked trine.
Yes,
those who ever have this locked trine, these people, they face, you can say, do not settle earlier than 30 or 31 years of their life. They might be doing small jobs and they might be losing these jobs very soon as they get. But the proper, jaise bolte na, people will settle.
Uh-huh.
They will marry and they will have a good job and they are earning good and they are supporting their family. That is not there until they cross the age of 50 years.
30, 31.
30 to 32 and a half actually.
So in that you only include the career aspect or even marriage wise you feel they don't?
No, this is only career. That's why I've written that. Yeah, career.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah, so this I had done it in a live seminar and there I didn't have enough time to do the whole thing systematically. But then this Lok Bhagya Chakra, okay. So many people will come and tell you, ki bhai, no, this is not working in my chart. So there are many riders to this rule also.
Okay.
But basically it works. And if I sit to tell the riders and how to do it, then it becomes a complete 2-hour session.
Okay.
Which I do in my classes. So at least this is a technique that people can see. If you see someone who is saying, "Arey, I'm not getting a fixed job, I'm not earning good money, or I have too many problems," then you can always go and search for this. Even if you don't know now.
Okay, so this is not if your second, sixth and tenth are empty. This can be
any
time are empty, then also this will have effect in career. Okay.
Correct. Any time. It does not matter which time.
Okay, got it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, out of the four trines, if it is empty and don't have Rahu Ketu, we don't have to take Rahu Ketu into account going on.
Okay.
So, let's do an example chart. Now, this first chart is of Julia Childs. She is a very famous American chef and has written 9 cookbooks.
Okay.
Appeared in more than 300 television shows.
Okay. But
if you see her chart, I will just mastering, this was her first book, Mastering the Art of Cooking in 1961. Okay. So if we see her chart, she is born in 1912. Okay. So let's start with Aries sign. There is no planet in Aries. Correct?
Yes. She has planet in Leo.
Yeah, she has planet. So this trine is not empty. Correct?
Yes, correct.
Then let's go to Taurus.
Yeah.
So she has moon over here.
Correct.
Correct. Let's go to Gemini.
Ah.
She has no planet over here.
Gemini is empty.
Yeah. So she wrote her first book in 1961.
Okay.
Okay. That's what I have got it from here. Cooking book, 1961. That is when she gained the celebrity status.
Oh, okay.
So when she was around 30 or 32, she was not at all interested in cooking. She used to do a very simple job of some secretary or some, not even secretary, some manual job at some company.
Okay.
And just for the heck of it, one day she went and decided to go and join some cooking class.
Okay.
That was after she was 33 or 34, I think.
Okay.
So she got this into cooking and she mastered this art of cooking and she became a celebrity only after 30 years.
Okay. Interesting.
Because of the MP.
Okay.
So in East, there are these planets. In South, this is the way to group them, to write them.
Yes.
Either you can write it in the cross, the red cross that I showed you. This is also one way of writing them.
Yeah.
Or you can just write it simply like this. Both the methods are good. Okay?
Yes.
So if we look at her chart now, there are two empty trines. Even 4, 8, 12 is it? No. One empty trine.
Yeah, Jupiter is there in 7. So
yeah, Jupiter is.
One trine is it.
So she worked very small jobs. So person having two empty trines, then it is 60 years.
Oh, sure.
But there are many riders to this rule. You know, many riders.
Okay, interesting.
So there was one of my clients, like he is not doing any work since he is born. And then we saw that he has two empty trines.
Achcha,
fully supported by his parents.
Okay.
He's nearly 50 years age now, maybe.
Okay.
So it's a very simple technique.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So she was a housewife and she worked very small jobs. After age of 40, she joined some cooking class. Sorry, I said 30. And at the age of 50, she became famous.
Okay.
So even for becoming famous, we have a very, very beautiful technique in Nadi that is called as Bhagyodaya Nadi. So that also we can time in our chart. Very beautiful. But again, okay. That will again be a very big session.
Okay.
So, and that is a little bit difficult if you don't know the basics, really. You should know Nadi to find out your that period, what is the best period in your life for me.
Okay.
Then there is one more, Gapping. You know this company. They are worldwide known for their jeans and everything. They have large chains. Donald Fisher. Again, he founded this company in 1969. And both he and his wife are the owners of this company, headquartered in San Francisco and California. Here again, he established himself after 40 years. Again, you can see an empty trine.
Okay, interesting.
Thank you. So here also we can see Jupiter and Sun in 159. Two also we have Mars,
yes,
Mercury, Venus. 3, 7, 11 is M. And 4 we have Saturn. 4, 8, 12 we have Saturn. So 1 trine is empty.
Yes.
So when exactly is this Lok Bhagya Chakra open? That again also is into Nadi. We have a technique for that. But for that, I have to move the planets.
Okay.
And progress them.
Okay. So this is one technique by which you can know that if this empty trine is there, after 30, 31, 32, stability will come, and then when it will come, then you have to use some other techniques for them.
Yes, you have to do a little bit advanced nadi like for all this. Okay. No? Because
it's like till 32 it's not happening, after that it will happen when that's different.
When that's different,
okay.
So this is the technique. Whenever I get charts, they saying ki I don't have stability, so this is the first thing I see in the chart.
Okay. And like one question somebody may get, if somebody has like no empty trine, then is there some specific definite rule like this, or is it general study of Nadi?
Yeah, there are many specific rules.
Okay.
Ketu ahead of Saturn is one such rule. This person also will settle after 31 years. Or 30 years, 32 years, like that, somewhere around. Like in this chart, if you can see Saturn and Ketu are sitting together.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
And 1 minute. Yeah. So Ketu is of a higher degree than Saturn.
Okay.
So this will definitely, after 30 years, one round completes in Libra sign. So Saturn, when crosses the degree of Ketu, then only he can start. Stability. The rules of Nadi are very simple, very easy to follow. I don't have to see D10, I don't have to see Dasha, I don't have to do. I'll just see Saturn, I'll see Ketu. For education, I'll see only Mercury. For getting married, I'll see only Mars and Venus, like that. So only Karatattvas of planets.
Here you mean this Saturn is in 19 degree, Ketu is in 11 degree. So
Ketu is, Ketu is 11 degree. Yeah, so same Saturn and Ketu sitting together.
Okay, so this,
after 30 years.
Which you said will apply only if they're together, or if suppose...
No, in any trine also.
Okay.
Or in 212 also. Like Saturn in first house and Ketu in the next house.
Okay.
So it is not that they will not work. They will start working. They can start working at a young age also. But they will not get jobs in which they earn much. They will not be stable. Now they have work. Now they don't have. Always these things are happening.
So this is like if Ketu is in Saturn is ahead of...
Ketu is ahead of Saturn.
Ketu is ahead of Saturn.
That is most worst. Yeah, that is more worst.
Okay.
And every time there is a transit of Ketu or Saturn on this combination, that is the time they will have this suffix again and again. Even after they are settled 30 years, 40 years.
Okay.
So whatever the reason may be, they might go for a holiday or something. They might fall sick and are not doing work for those few days. Whatever the reason. But there will be a break in their work somehow or the other.
Okay.
Not necessary that they are leaving that same job they are doing. Nothing like that. So, if you remember now, Saturn and Ketu were together in...
Yes.
Yeah. So, there were so many problems with employment and everything.
Okay. So, this is...
So many things.
This Saturn Ketu thing holds true for employment, and for marriage, you said it is Mars and Venus.
Yeah. We don't take Jupiter as a husband in Nadi. We take Mars as a husband. He's the character of husband. Mars.
Okay, so in that, what is the rule? Same if Mars is ahead of Venus?
No. The rules are different every year.
Oh, so for every planet it's different.
Every planet it is different. Every planet we have to see in a different way.
Oh, I thought for career we take this Sun, I thought, but I didn't know it's Saturn and Ketu. It's a bit surprising.
No, Saturn is the Karma Karakana.
Okay.
Sun is only your fame and name and government jobs.
Okay, correct.
Saturn is the Karma Karaka. So we have to see Saturn.
Okay. Any reason behind why Ketu?
Ketu is an obstructor. He is also called as a destiny breaker around Ketu.
Okay, so you are taking Saturn as this thing related to career and obstruction. So that is why this Saturn Ketu is about career.
Yes.
Okay, interesting. Okay, very good, very good. And this is true for any ascendant, any moon sign, any...
Yeah. See, I have taken any, no? Now here she is Gemini ascendant over here.
Okay.
Correct. So we take the ascendants for many, many things.
Okay.
But the techniques are easy. Like even if the if you don't know the birth time and you know the birth date. So you can do many predictions just by casting a Kalpurushkuti of that day.
Okay.
So here it is Taurus ascendant, there is this Gemini.
So suppose
one trine is empty.
Okay. So suppose somebody says that I don't have birth details and they have Ketu ahead of Saturn on that day, maybe.
Yes.
So then you can say they
You can tell them ki this is there. If you see an empty trine in that, you can say this is there. Then other various combinations can also say ki kabhi marriage ho, when you are getting married. Or when you will have problems, or when is a good time. Many things you can see.
Okay. Yeah, this is interesting. Saturn Ketu, I have never heard of it before.
Yeah, Nadi is really very interesting, very easy. If you just know the basics of Rasha, like 12 Rashis, 9 planets, and their karakas, then you all can do Nadi. Anyone can do Nadi and learn it.
Okay. So they just have to know the rules, clear cut, defined.
Not as such, because many, many rules are lost also. Now we have lost lots of
pages.
And converting from the South Indian languages to English language is also a little bit difficult. And each teacher has their own interpretation of whatever they read there and bring it away.
Yeah, what they think is right, wrong.
Correct.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah. So let me stop sharing.
Amazing. This is
I hope the session people will understand this simple rules. Yeah. I will try to bring more such simple rules, maybe a combinations of planets or somewhere.
Yeah, I mean next time we can do some session on timing of like promotion or timing of marriage.
No, that is not possible in sessions, because for that I have to teach the whole Nadi.
Okay, very, very.
I need to think of topics like which will be easily understood. Okay. Whoever does not know Nadi also.
Okay. And if people are.
Otherwise, you need to know Nadi for timing and everything.
Okay. And
if
people
if you learn Parashar for timing, yeah. Then you need to see Dasha and everything. But yeah. You know, should know the rules of Parashar, right?
Yeah, of course.
Same
yes.
Way in Nadi also.
Okay. And if people are interested to learn this, where they can go from you?
Yeah, sure. Anytime. Classes are happening all the time with me.
Okay. So I'll give madam's website. You have a website if I'm right. Okay. And your YouTube channel. So you can go, and you also will be doing consultations, I guess.
Yeah, but I'm more interested in teaching and everything.
Okay. So whoever wants to teach, you can go to her website, and whoever.
Of course, I do consultations, but I love teaching.
Okay, and whoever wants consultations, you can also go, okay. Or teaching, whichever is comfortable for you. Thank you very much. Hope to see you back with another interesting shortcut technique like this to understand. Thank you very much.
Thank you for inviting me.